Well, first off, Jamie, the White House is saying this is a real example of the country coming together to be able to fight the virus and its impacts. But one congressman tells me that the federal response is consistently undercutting what the actual need is. Let's take the payroll protection program for a second and look at the impact it had on Washington just in the first round. Remember, there were $350 billion that was put toward this program. In Washington, that translated to about 30,000 loans for small businesses here in our state. It totaled nearly $7 billion. But if we look at the total impact of small businesses in our state, if we move on to the next slide on your screen, just about 5% of Washington's small businesses were able to get that loan. So that's 95% of businesses who did not get this type of federal relief. We're not saying that every single one of those small businesses did apply, but as you hear from Steve Kiggins' reporting and so much of our reporting in the past couple of weeks, there are a lot of businesses that have been looking for this help. So now we have round two for the payroll protection program, $310 billion. Well, two congressional members in our state, Congressman Derek Kilmer and Congresswoman Jamie Herrera Butler, have called for three times that amount. Congressman Kilmer tells me why.
As you look at how our economy generally makes it out of recessions, it's not the big guys that are growing the jobs. Generally, about 60% of job growth coming out of recession is small businesses. And you know, not only are they the backbone of our economy, I kind of think of them as your star running back, right? They're the ones that are racking up the tough yards. They're the ones that are scoring the touchdowns. I think part of the role, particularly in the midst of this pandemic, is to do some blocking for our star running backs and to call some plays for them. And I think by putting far more resources into this Paycheck Protection Program, we can unleash beast mode.
Well, it's a pretty good analogy for here in Western Washington, but Congressman Kilmer tells me as long as they continue to add even $300 billion, which sounds like so much money, a little bit at a time, that Congress is going to continue playing whack-a-mole with the actual need that we're seeing across our country when it comes to this. One of the conversations we'll likely be hearing as the House moves to pass this new stimulus package is putting sufficient guardrails in place to make sure this money is going specifically to small businesses, not businesses that have significant liquidity.